first chest, we have all the Ghostbusters equipment. You know, the proton packs. MK1, MK2, MK3, MK4, and the one from the Extreme Ghostbusters. Let's just select all of those. And the Neutrona one. MK1, MK2, MK3, MK4, and the Extreme Ghostbusters Neutrona one. We also have a throwable ghost trap, a normal ghost trap, RC ghost trap, and a PKE meter. We also have all three of the Ectomobiles, and a spawn egg for Egon Spank. So, we don't actually have to wear these proton packs. They only have to be in your inventory, so, yeah. The Neutrona wands actually don't work without their, proton packs. For example, if you remove the MK4 proton pack, the Neutrona wand MK4 won't fire. So, let's just get back the MK4. Oh crap. And next up is the ghost traps. So, to power them, you'll need a pressure plate and redstones. So, create a simple line of redstone with a pressure plate at the end, and put a ghost trap on the other end of the line. Step off of the pressure plate, the ghost trap closes. It's a little cool lightning thing. And this is actually a really cool thing because it can actually catch the ghost, which we'll be covering later. There's also the throwable ghost trap, which you can throw at ghosts. So, make it really want to feel like a Ghostbuster in Minecraft, I suggest just doing all this hard stuff. So, next up we have the PKE meter, the trusty PKE meter. And this thing can actually detect ghosts. So, for example, let's get a normal ghost here. Now let's move on to all three of the Ectomobiles. We got the Ecto one, the Rusty Ecto one, and the Ecto one from the Extreme Ghostbusters. So let's place down the Ecto one, like so, and let's get in. So you can't actually see in first person, so you have to go in third person. Ghostbusters theme, and you can also turn on the extra and the other variations are just the Ecto one that's slightly altered. Here we have the Rusty Ecto one. As we can see, the ladder is on the left side and not the right side, so that it can make way for the gunner seat in the actual Ghostbusters Afterlife movie. It's a little bit rusty, and the Ecto-1 Extreme is basically the Ecto-1, but it has a few minor changes, just like I said. It's it has a logo on the hood of the car, and it has these like rail things on the front. I don't know what they're called. And yeah, so let's move on to the ghosts. We got Minipuff, Muncher, Bug Eye Ghost, Spectra, Impy, Slimer, and Stay Puft. Let's just bust out the Neutrono arm and the Throwable Ghost Truck. So the first one is Slimer. He's the Sedgwick ghost, the first ghost the boys in Shining Proton Packs ever caught. So let's just catch him in this trap. And as you can see, he has caught the trap. And when you actually collect it, it says Slimer. So it says that you've actually captured the ghost. It says what ghost is actually inside it. So that's kind of cool. Next up, we got Impy. So I think this is from like the real Ghostbusters. I don't know. Never watched it. And then the next one is Spectra. It's a Spectre. Neutrona wand, and it can fly. And again, Throwable Ghost Trap. Next one is a Bug Eye Ghost. Now this one is actually really hard to capture, since, well, traps just bounce off of it. I don't know how to trap it. Traps just, well, bounce off of it. So I'm gonna use a MK4 or an Extreme Ghostbusters. Maybe that'll get it down the hill. No, so basically, I don't think there's any way to trap this Bug Eye Ghost. So next up, we got Muncher, the Ghostbusters Afterlife version of Slimer, basically. You can shoot it just like any other ghost, and when you throw a trap, it gets captured. Ghost Trap, Muncher. Alright, the next thing is the Minipuff. These are really hard to kill, because you can just shoot them with your neutron, and they and now, on to the next things. Now, I forgot to mention one ghost, and that's when you destroy you get this really cool music discs, the Ghostbusters mod theme. Now I'm scared that when I play that music disc, I'm gonna be copyrighted, so I'm not gonna play that. And let's see the other ones in the chest. We got Gozer's Skull, Ghost Trap Invert, Keymaster Statue, Gatekeeper Statue, Ghostbuster Sign, and the Container Grid. Let's just get rid of some of this stuff. First off, the Container Grid. It's really simple how it works. Get a ghost trap with a ghost in it. Tap, add ghost. Lights green, traps clean. You can move on with your life. Next one is the Ghostbusters sign. And it's basically just the sign that goes on top of the firehouse. Ghostbusters. Next one is, it actually has a really cool purpose. The Gatekeeper statue and the Keymaster statue. Now, when you use some ritual books, shown here, when you use these ritual books, you can actually spawn the Gatekeeper and the Keymaster, which then spawns ghosts, like in the original movie. And then the ghost trap in dirt. Now, I haven't actually tested out this thing, so let's see if it works, I guess. It has a real ghost trap, so that's also really cool. And here are some things that I just needed to mention. First off, we got the Ecto Cooler. And this is basically from the 80s, based off of the Ghostbusters. And, yeah, it's really cool they added this in here. Because recently, Ghostbusters Twitter account announced that they will be sending out Ecto Cooler to random people or something. And next up is the Twinkie and the Gozer Rituals book. The Twinkie, you can eat. And if you ever watch Ghostbusters, you know that this was used as an analogy by Egon for how much spectral activity there is in New York City. So, that's about it for the video. Smash like and subscribe. Tell all your friends about how good this video is. And I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.